Today we're going to talk about the dreaded C word. I'm talking chemicals. Ugh, there, I said it. And despite what you've heard, I want you to know, chemicals are not bad words. In fact, chemicals make up some extraordinarily good things, including, well, us. We are lovely chemical compositions made mostly of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen. And if chemicals can make us, well, they can't be that bad, right? Chemicals are present in everything in the world we live in and are responsible for our entire sensory experience. Everything we see, smell, feel, or taste is a result of chemicals and their intimate interactions. If you want to get smart about beauty, then you need to get familiar with chemicals. To get started, here are a few things you should know. Chemicals can be bad or good. It depends on how they're being used. Chlorine can be bad if inhaled in high doses. It can cause a person to die. But a little can be good in public drinking water, where it kills bacteria and saves lives. Chemicals act differently, depending if and how they're bonded. To illustrate the point, we're going to talk about rice and beans. No, 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 not rice and beans. Rice and beans. They come from the plant that produces castor oil. By themselves, rice and beans can be a toxic poison if ingested or injected. However, react ricin with zinc and get zinc ricinolate, a harmless deodorant. Chemical reactions can be violent, but that doesn't mean the end result has to be hazardous. Sodium hydroxide can eat through skin, and when combined with water and fat, it produces heat, about 200 degrees worth. This all seems scary until you find out that violent chemical reactions can produce some wonderfully wholesome products, like glycerin, which is nourishing for the skin, and the mother of all natural products, soap. Mother Nature isn't always best. In perfumery, the eco-friendly prefer synthetic sandalwood over natural. That warm, woodsy sandalwood scent is the smell of trees on the verge of extinction. Ethical perfumers refuse natural sandalwood and instead use synthetic alternatives like sandalore to replicate the scent. Now that we feel a little more comfortable with the word chemical, we can start digging into what makes up some of our beauty products. I'm really looking forward to going over this in future episodes, and I want to thank you guys for joining me. This is Miss Beautyphile signing out.